not a hacker. He just came to repair the air conditioner plant of the Target headquarter, and he got accidentally into this Target network. Target was never ever a target, right? But the guy who was a simple AC engineer, he found vulnerability and got into the Target network. Our network is the best secure. I explained you about the product in my first slide, so you may be worried now that, okay, boss, this guy, this chap is taking care of my data, how secure it is. Obviously, because that's what business was also saying, that okay, it is bank's business, it is bank's responsibility that if I am giving you mobile banking, I am giving an app, it is my responsibility to make sure it is safe and secure. It is not the consumer or the customer who is using that app, because he's a layman, that guy don't know. You know what, the state of this country, Jan Dhan Yojana is one of the successful model of Prime Minister Modi, right? We issued around 200 million plus debit card in this country for the people, those who become the new member of banking system. They're not like you and me, having access of the banking system. They are completely new people, those who have not seen the landline ever in their life. They have given iPhone 7, like a guy use it. Okay, what the guy did? I got a complaint from one bank, there is some fraud and this guy has registered a complaint. That he inserted a card and but card does not recognize. Then I investigated, okay, but because we have card vendor, those manufacturer and all, so we investigated, was there anything wrong in their system? They said, no, everything's fine. The entire batch, they produce, they're working well. Then I asked that bank, that can you please call that customer and check what exactly has wrong with this card? Can you take photocopy and send me? The guy literally sent a photocopy. You will laugh, but at the same time, take it seriously. The reason why, that's a population, that's the kind of people in this country which we have to deal with. The guy said that in my whole street of in his village, he was the first man to open bank account in all his generation, and he nicely laminated this card because someone told that this card is very very valuable, you have to keep it secure. He laminated the card and he was trying to insert in ATM to get the money. It is not about the 18% people living in India. It is about the 80% people living in Bharat. And we have to deal with the cyber security challenges with those kind of people. And if I say that my network is the best, rather I myself is overconfident or I'm telling lie. Okay? I would say always that I'm adequately secure, but I can't say that I'm secure because nobody knows that what the zero day vulnerability is in our system. It will never happen with me. Again, same or confident. And last, don't take as an offhand those who are ISO or PCI companies, but this is something, okay, just to give a peace of mind to yourself that I am ISO 9000, I am ISO 27000. You know what, this, sorry, don't take it again as an offense, but we all Mumbaikar have seen what the state of compliance in PCI or ISO. We have gone through the Charasta signal. We come with bike. I'm sure you must have noticed, but you are not mapped with my thought. So what will happen? We see there is a police constable standing at this signal. The biker, what he will do? He'll pull out slowly the helmet, wear in his head. The moment he crosses the signal, again he'll pull it out and put it again on the hook of the bike. It is a compliance. Because I want to show this police wala that says, I am wearing helmet, don't catch me. Don't catch me. That's not the requirement. And that's what exactly we are doing. Tick mark when auditor is to come, or our IS audit is going to happen, PCI scan is going to happen. We all are busy in doing tick mark, tick mark, tick mark. It's not a one day affair. It's not just to park the signal. You're not, see, when you are at signal, you are at the zero speed or 5 or 10 kilometer speed.
Not at 100 kilometer, right?
So that's the state of, and that's where we are finding ourselves, we are secure because we are ISO and all this. No, it's not. So every data breach, if you see in this country, you can see by 2012 to 2016, almost double, just in 4 years. It's going exponentially high, it's rapidly growing. And all put together, the risk is not a technology, or only technology risk, the cyber security risk is not which is to be managed by a fork sitting in front of the server or in front of the firewall or no, it is a business risk, because if something goes wrong, then you will be pulled down heavily. It is just a matter of the company which you have, or conglomerate which you have, you know, built up for many, many decades. It takes one day. What happened with Target? You will live about the latest one in the Bangladesh Bank, the Swift. The credibility come at the question, right? So what is going to drive cyber security, or especially the security risk by 2020 in this country? The first one, I'm not sure whether it's too much legible, but I'll just quickly cover it. The infrastructure revolution. We are talking about IoT and metro going on, and even we are also coming out with one product called the mobility card, where you can use for Mumbai metro or Western Railway or Central Railway. You can use the same card in West and all this, right? The revolution of data is a key for today's growth. We all are very very excited to get 4G. My SIM card got from 3G to 4G. Okay, but at the same time, the speed at what the virus and Trojan and all will enter in your mobile or on your device is equally so fast. Be careful. The second, the data explosion. Data explosion, the way we are generating data, I think it is not TB or GB. I think it is 1%. You can imagine the kind of data what we are creating today. And that is what is going to be a challenge, unless it is safely secure and proper access control are given on the data. You can imagine what can go wrong with this data. Always on, always connected. One teenager died, he committed the suicide. You know, for what? He uploaded his photo and he had an expectation that at least 50 friends will like my photograph in first 50 minutes. And he could not achieve the target. This is a reality. Because that has gone in their mind that, yes, when I'm connected, everyone should click, like, or comment on my photograph instantly. We can afford to leave our important document at home. We can leave our key at home. Imagine if you have forgotten your mobile at your home. Can you? We can't, because we all are having the same mental that I have to be connected, because what will kill them if I'm offline? It's a big crime for me. I can't be. That's going to further drive the risk. The future finance. As I told you, I have just narrated about the case about the debit card. We are going to deal with the same community, same people, and we are expanding our future finance, like new payment banks are coming, the small bank are coming, the way financial inclusion is going on. So, you know, you have to deal with those kind of people. They are literate, and not about the people, those who are in village. There are literate people, including IPS officer and I am Bangalore professor, who have given their username, password and OTP to fraudsters. Tougher regulation and standard. As Vijesh was saying about, there is a national cyber security policy which is rolled out in 2013. Nobody has taken note, but now it's time. It's time the government and all machinery is thinking to bring more and more. See, in India there is no data privacy law. Very soon this will be introduced. And that is going to change the whole dynamic of risk management around cybersecurity. So new identity which we are bringing with Aadhaar and iris-based scanning, that is also going to change. So these are the massive, massive driver which is going to change the whole dynamic of the cybersecurity and the risk associated with the cybersecurity. So what are the challenges? I think she's telling me to quickly sum up this. So I'll just quickly cover up. So crux of this compliance, which I just told about, the simple compliance, the normal checklist-based compliance or checklist-based control is not going to work. It is no more static world in which we are. We will have to be dynamic, not only on the usability of the technology, but when it comes to safety and security, we have to be equally dynamic to manage those risks. So if I have to sum up, how to manage cyber security in today's dynamic world? You must have established cyber security, cyber risk governance. That is first and foremost. Because just, you know, bringing from someone, somewhere, someone has implemented that policies and laws and rules and, you know, things like that in their company, it may not work in your company. Simple, because unless you define your risk boundary, what you want to protect? Everything is not crucial. Everything is not those so sensitive. Define boundary. Identify what you want to cover, you know, secure. Accordingly, you assess the cyber threat according to this, the criticality of your asset. And finally, you have to have plan and respond. Unless you have very strong incident response or cyber response plan, all your preparation may not work, because otherwise what will happen, we will have to just see data is going out or our system is getting down and we are helpless. So this is something new gen security architecture which is the most important today, because single layer just using two-factor authentication or a simple firewall route is not going to solve the problem, because the way threats are coming, it is multiple from all the direction, even from insider and outsider. Unless we have, you know, multi-fold, multi-directional control in our system, this will continue to be a problem. So why to secure in digital world? The customer trust. Once, there is a survey, I was reading yesterday only, that report which has come from one of the non-institute, that once customer has fallen into trap of fraudster, and if he has lost some money, 50% people tend not to use debit or credit card for a long period. That's simple one statistic. In one particular shop, if you go and you are cheated, most likely you are not going to go. Right? Same analogy work here also, as well as in cybercrime. The regulatory compliance, as I said, India has law, but there is a teethless law which is going to be changed. Some change already we have seen, and that is what is going to make sure that you have to follow those rules and regulations. Security is the foundation. Any of the product which I just say, of my product, security is inherent part from the day one. Quality and security, these are the two things, cannot be added at a last stage, come what may. It is Apple, it is Facebook, it is Google or anybody. They cannot bring quality and security at last stage. It has to be a foundation. And the safeguard from risk, that's the ultimate objective for which you need to follow this system. I think, what is the future of security and risk? If I sum up this whole conversation, what I started a half an hour ago, and what I foresee in future, there will be a dynamic authentication. The way we are doing our identity, so it is no more going to be as static as what we see today. It will be completely dynamic. There will be powerful security. Let the stakeholder remain away from the vulnerable data. Intelligent response, because as I said, we in financial sector or in the sector where we are working, there is no call rollback. You know, in automobile, the people take as a pride. Okay, Nissan has called 1 lakh so and so vehicle back. They called back. It is coming as a, you know, big news item that Suzuki has called back 1,000. Do we have, once it's gone, transaction has happened, money is gone, it's gone. We don't have that pride to, can be taken that we have called back that money. No, we can't. Right? That's where the intelligent response is required, immediate response. Solution that engage consumer, because we as a layman, we are bothered about the security, but don't leave the security in consumer's hand. Don't expect him to be fully educated and fully intelligent enough to respond to those kind of security or security issues what he may come across. It is not his job. Let him do shopping. Let him do the ease of transaction. And innovation, leadership and collaboration, because very nice example what Bridges was talking about in Israel. The guy at the academia, the guy from industry and the guy from government. Unless there is a seamless transaction, seamless, coherent, framework to tackle these kind of issues. Probably we are heading towards that. Yes, we are not that foolproof today, but I am sure that by 2020 we will have that stage where we as a country will have coordinated effort and coordinated collaboration among all this machinery. So, this is my last slogan, that life is a balance between risk and benefit. Thank you very much. That's it from my side. Thanks for listening. I have 2 minutes for question and answer. Okay.
Hello. Are you, your company or any of the companies, are they planning to issue insurance for banks to, so that they encourage the digital thing? Right now, I'm not very sure of the losses in case there are frauds.
Okay, my company is not in that business, sorry. But I can definitely tell you. See, I have taken security cyber risk insurance. Cyber risk insurance, when I was in my previous company, I was in Citibank in 2006-2007. They were talking about the cyber risk insurance, which in India it was completely new jargon. Then what is the cyber risk insurance? That continued till a couple of years ago, up to 2013 and also. You know what? Last year, India is the one of the top countries paid a huge ransomware to fraudster, which has not come anywhere in our newspaper, right? We are not aware, but huge money companies has given as a ransomware, and that threat has increased the business of cyber risk insurance. It is available. It is now, I would say that maximum of the majority of insurance companies are offering the cyber risk insurance.
One question I have is, with the advent of the cloud world, everything moving into cloud, the likes of Azure or AWS or Google Cloud for the matter, how do you think security is still a concern for organizations that don't have anything on their desktops or even in their environment anymore? They just have processes, and those processes even are not running on their environment. Everything is now in the cloud. And all those protocols are, let's say, HIPAA compliant, PCI compliant. I understand there is a reservation with respect to those compliances also, but they definitely have a much better, robust security spectrum than what we could have in our own environment. So how do you see that change?
So good question. I'll answer in non-technical way. So we in Hindu mythology, we believe that there is someone who runs this universe, who is controlling this whole universe. Nobody has seen, right? We don't know who the guy is controlling our breath and everything. But we have believed that there is someone. So 99% of people believe that when it comes to remembering a God, we always see the cloud. There is somebody behind this cloud. He has his own computer system. He has his database. He has security admin. We have just faith that ultimately he is the guy. He don't, he don't differentiate between poor guy and rich guy. He has common law for everybody. That's the state of cloud security, what I believe. Thank you.